Thanks for joining. Everyone who was earlier in our first webinar today, thanks again and welcome back. Quick information up front. So as you all know, the Atlassian Remote Summit is happening today and tomorrow as a replacement of the on-site summit in Vegas. And we're conducting several webinars to supplement the Atlassian Remote Summit keynotes and breakout sessions, just to give you an overview as we cannot meet in person in Las Vegas this year. So we are happy to catch up with you here and showcase some of the use cases we are working on with our add-ons to help you improve the daily work of your Jira and Confluence users. With our little add-ons here, we are, if you're wondering, Stagel, I see some existing customers of ours, but also some new names. So I just wanted to introduce Stagel real quick. We are an Atlassian Platinum Solution Partner. So we're focusing on all the services that a partner provides, like consulting, training, hosting, license management, everything you can think of in the Atlassian ecosystem. And we're also a top vendor for the Atlassian Marketplace. So today will be about customizing Jira and Confluence. And for this use case, we will use actually two of our add-ons, because this add-on is available for Jira and Confluence. So we will show you how you can customize these tools for your users. And my colleague, Marie, will guide you through the webinar. So just a few sentences about Marie and I. So my name is Daniel. I'm working for Stagel as Atlassian expert and director of the North American operations. And my colleague Marie, based out of Berlin, is an Atlassian expert and also one of our marketing experts. Marie will guide you through the webinar and show our add-on, the configuration and the use cases, and that will be available for questions. So you can enter your questions into the chat or in the Q&A part of that webinar, and I will be there to answer them. Marie, are you ready? Did I forget something?
Yes, maybe we should start with the information we posted last on the last webinar. So can offer you a discount here. So if you're evaluating to introduce navigation for Jira or Confluence soon, we can provide you 20% discount for every webinar attendee. And yes, thank you for introduction again, Daniel. So I will start navigating. And also, just like in the other webinar, start, what are the limitations of Jira and Confluence navigation? So navigation bar has fixed standard entries. They are not changeable, and every team has the same navigation. And if you install a new add-on, they will create their own navigation element, and you can't hide it if you need it or not. And so far, there's also no seamless shift between Jira and Confluence. And especially in Jira, it's hard to adjust navigation. I mean, for Confluence, there are several other design add-ons which are doing a good job. But especially in Jira, there is a huge bottleneck to get more individualization here. So the benefit of what we are trying with Stagil Navigation is to give more flexibility here so that you can customize the top and or project navigation, the footer and Jira issue screen based on your team and needs. So the result should be that the navigation through Jira and Confluence should feel as you are not leaving the system. So you can design both equal so that you have the feeling that you are just in your system working. And also with that, you can follow your corporate identity guideline and yeah, or just as improve the appearance of Jira and Confluence. So here again, have a look. Let's have a look. That was just a little introduction. And now we will go to the system and look about what I mean. Some of you maybe already recognize in the other session we had that it's looking like very colorful. It's we designed our demo instance in the Stegir colors and also added this little Star Wars clothes theme, so to say, here. So we added a banner here to have like more the individual feeling that you're playing with a death egg. So here are the navigation entries, which are completely adaptable. You can select little icons for every entry or not. You can define your own entries with different options. You can set like filter links here, or you can add board links, dashboard. Here you also have the separator. We will have a look into how it's configured. And here's just to show about what is possible. Or you can have like HR information. And actually, when we move to Confluence, so here we are in Jira, and we when we move in Confluence, we have the same bar, and we can design it like completely the same. So here are different entries now. So you still can have, of course, your own entries here in Confluence, your own navigation, but it would be also possible to like have exactly the same if you want to, so that the user really feels they are not moving the system, they stay in their environment and they just get their stuff done where they need, no matter if they are in Confluence or Jira. And what's also special here is that you can configure which team and which user group should be have which navigation. So it's completely configurable, not only that you can individualize, but you can also individualize it per teams. So now I'm logged in as the admin. And to show you that, I will log out and show how this will look like when I log in as developer. So now we have less entries than we saw before. Like here was a PM entry, which is missing, or there was also a support entry, which is not here anymore. And based on the role as as a development user, as part of the development team, he's more specialized or enabled to see the dev teams so that he has an overview about the different teams that he has and can watch over, or that he can also have a quick look to the product backlog of the portfolio, for instance. So, and that's, of course, about customizable about your needs. So based on the roles, project managers, developers, marketing, HR team, you can design like really your own navigation for each team. So now I will log out again. And log in back as administrator. To show you how this can work. So when you install the add-on, you have your own configuration here. So that's all which comes with Stegir navigation. And I will start to go through each of one so that you know about what's happening behind. So the top navigation, that's like what I just explained, that you can make your own entries here. And first of all, you can see like all system, whether it's a system-based entry or not. So projects obviously is a system-based. And of course we have like issues here, or if you install Tempo or Big Picture, you also have them here. But here you can decide, should the people see it or not? So if you think that Big Picture is a project management tool and only project manager and maybe dear administrators should see it, you can decide it here. And but if all of your users should log time and use Tempo, of course everybody should see it. So on the one side you have the whitelisting, but you can also do it the other way around, so that you say any logged in user can see it except that certain kind of user group. Here are the icons which I mentioned that you can define. You can also leave it empty and have no icons. So it's up to you. And what else we have is like the different entry possibility options. So for product management, we decided to have a sub-navigation. So that when you go here, that you have a list of several other options. And this could be also JQL, this can be web links where you can connect to Confluence or also to some other external web pages. This can be other projects, agile boards or also dashboards. And what you do to have a new entry here is that you create a new one, like product management was created here. And then you go to manage. And here in manage, you can just add the other ones. So when we go back to how it looks like, we see that it starts with a separator. We can see it because here request is just a title of the group. So to have a better overview. And here's another separator to indicate that no more project relevant entries will appear. So that's what you're doing here, that you first having a separator with request, do the other entries you want to have under it, and afterwards having another separator with projects. And here we have request a new project, and you can just enter the URL which should be visible here. And also here you can decide which user group should see it. If it's for anybody who can see that navigation entry anyway, or also in this group, if there are some people who should see other stuff than other people. So it's completely up to you. And besides of the web links, you can also have like this agile boards. And if you have a look here, when we go to manage, you can, for instance, to decide that every Kanban board should be visible here or like a certain board which you want to show up there when you go to the PM navigation. And the same is also with projects and dashboards. So in that way, I think you got an idea about how this is working now. So maybe we can also have a look. Here are some assets. And here that is obviously based on the on a JQL. So you can see all assets from type space shuttles here and from type buildings and planets. And so it's just simply as that. And of course you can decide to only filter my assets just on based on what you need. When we go to the next configuration step, you can also have a project configuration. And what is meant by that? So when we go to the asset management project, for instance, then you have the sidebar. And it's like pretty similar about what we have in the top navigation here, that you can also configure the sidebar entries here. So what we have here with assets and the different JQL, you can also implement it here, just on where you need the information and where you need access to. So that's where you can do it on project base as well. So we have some configuration for a CMDB project here, for instance. And the assets one is the one which we just saw here for assets. And there are also sub-navigation, but you can also add a big picture program or also external web links with external information connected to that project. When we go to the next one.
You can, Marie, maybe you want to show the iframe as well. That was just came up with another customer the other day. What they liked, they're using it a lot, is the iframes. So it's also interesting to actually include an iframe in your project navigation on the left side. If you have any external links or content that you would like to show within the project navigation.
Yeah. So here we have our website.
Yeah. So it's a pretty cool feature.
Yeah. So that you're not even leaving your system to provide external information. Thank you, Daniel. So what else we have is the footer. So normally you have, I think you all know it. If you have this enabled, you just have this Atlassian information about version and Jira and report problems. And here you also have the option to make it appear a bit more personal towards your company. So you can also add your company logo or something else and specify an own footer navigation as well, so that you can find additional information or just go directly to your help center. And yeah, the logic is like quite similar. So you just enter about what entry you want to have. So like info or services, which are then the title here. And if you manage each of them, then you can define other links. I will show you. So that you can enter your data policy or imprint or what other information you just need here instead of the default Atlassian ones. So that's it for the footer. Then I go to the next, that's the issue navigation. To the other add-on we showed you, you can enter the white form so that you have a wider issue form when you open a new issue. And what's also very interesting is that you can define the issue tab behavior. So with that, you can define how this panel should look like when you open an issue, if this should be closed or it should be opened. So we see here that the description is closed, open, but there's no description, but attachment and tempo, it's closed. And that's because it was configured, then tempo and attachment should be closed panels. So here you can define which panels on your issue should be open and which one should be closed or which one should be even hidden. And when you go for it, then Easter egg again, you can see that here. And what you could also do, like, maybe this is a server that's some kind of CMDB, and I don't want to lock time, so I don't need this tempo panel here. So I have the possibility to just move it. And when I update the issue, I shouldn't be able to see the tempo panel again. So it's still loading. I mean, of course, you have to be careful that you know how you configured it and for which one. So if a panel is not showing up, that you have in mind that it could be also Shtigi Navigation who's hiding that panel. Yeah, and here's just one more chance again to make it just more according to your needs about how every panel should look like when you open it. And that one you can also, we have it now with, I showed it to you with projects, but of course you can also do it with project categories or also with issue type or user groups. So here we had the issue type server and the user group Jira administrator. But if you maybe you only want to have a certain kind or group of people who should lock time or something, you can also hide for other groups panels so that also only some people can use it. So that was about the issue navigation. What comes at is like the global theme and style. So you have some basic options about designing the navigation, and we just provide you more possibility. Like this header here, we have some default here, but you can just enter your own one and have this option about scaling, where should it be positioned, about background colors. And when you go to the next tab, you can also do with the whole navigation. So you can define which color should be here and what color should when I type in background colors. So you can just make it more appeal to your corporate design. And on top of that, you could also define it for projects. So if you say that for other projects, I want to have another header because they have, I don't know, it's more maybe a thing about identification with the project, maybe so that you want for certain projects, also certain banners here on the top to pop up. You can also do it here in the edit mode and choose another picture which you can update for certain projects. So that's a project related one. And finally, you can also do some field renaming. We implemented for some customers who requested that, so that you can say it should not be summary, but it should be called ticket. And now it didn't work out.
Oh, you have to reload the page first.
Yeah.
Usually that happens to me sometimes as well.
So here we just renamed summary to ticket. So that's what we did for some customers, but I also want to say that you have to be careful here because when you want to use it for JQL, you still have to type in summary. So it's not that you're typing in for ticket. And for some users, this might get confusing. So it's an option you can use, but you have to think about where it makes sense and how you could use it. So this was our tour. I navigated you to all points. That was the Jira one. And now I finally just want to say about some difference in Confluence. So here we have the navigation for Confluence, which is basically the same. So you have the top navigation where you can define your entries. Here's the place where you can makes the same appeal as in Jira. And on top of that, you have the space navigation, which is also very interesting in terms of permission, because you can define certain space categories, like here, knowledge base CEO blog, and you can maybe say that this is blacklisted to a certain kind group of people, because only people with CEO permission should be able to see that space. And that's also something you can coordinate here. So, and the same, you can also do this with page navigation. So you can decide that the copy page is blacklisted for any logged in user. So if I want to copy this page, I just can't do it. And for any reason, maybe you have a time of maintenance or something where you don't want people to copy the content, or what use case would be possible, you can decide it here. And also for any other button in the page navigation. So you can just decide also here about where some limitations can also be useful. So that are the two differences. But the other one, you can decide for the same footer, have the same header theme as we did it in our Jira and conference to appear the same, so that you have more of this feeling to work in one system and to have this seamless integration feeling, for which makes it, especially for the users, much easier to navigate and to orientate in your systems. So that was it from my side. So I didn't have an eye on the questions which might came up. So I would just give back to Daniel if there are some questions to clarify or something we want to discuss in group.
Thank
again.
You, Marie. Thank you for the overview. No questions so far. So looks like the features are pretty clear, I guess. These add-ons, they just give you a nice functionalities for customizing these apps. And as we mentioned, our remote summit discount is available, so just reach out to us. Here are our contact information. And if you have any questions, now is the time to type them into the chat. If not, I guess everyone is now thinking about the use cases they have for their users. Okay, we got one question. When you add a Confluence page to a sidebar, when you click on it, it opens another tab.
You can define that as well. What was it when you add a Confluence page?
When you add a Confluence to a sidebar, do you mean to a sidebar in Jira, like in the menu? So maybe, Marie, you can, first of all, in Jira or a URL. Yes, in Jira. Okay, so... you can define if it should open in a new tab or an existing one. Maybe you can show that here. Wait, you need to go to a URL, not a sub-navigation.
So let's take the PM again. Here we are. So yeah, same tab, and you can also decide for new tab if you update it. And when you go to request a new project, then I should refresh it first. Yeah, but it's possible.
And maybe you showed earlier that you can rename the standard Jira fields like summary. And you can also rename the issue type and the project. Maybe you want to quickly just rename all three and then create a new ticket to see what it looks like. No, I mean system fields. Sorry, field renaming. So let's say a project might be a space.
And here, I don't know.
Issue type is like, now the, yeah, the issue type might be just task type or something, or type, yeah, summary title is ticket in that case. And then you go back to a project, just reload. And then when you hit the create button, you will have the new names for it.
So here
you see, space, type, ticket. But again, you have to be careful because if users get used to that, they might forget that they still need to use the, for example, for the ticket, the summary, issue summary, they still need to search for the summary in the JQL instead of the new name ticket, because that's what we cannot change on a database level. But it's more about the appearance here, and you might have users who are not searching for the summary, or who don't even use the JQL. I know that it's frightening some people as well, the JQL. So, but these are apparently real life use cases, as this has been requested by a few customers, and that's why we implemented it.
And we also plan to extend it so that you also do it with assignee, for instance, and for other system fields. So,
yeah,
that's an option you can do.
Okay. There are no more questions so far.
Yeah, I think we have it then for today. So a lot of you also signed up for our webinars tomorrow. So we will have another one tomorrow about Stagil Assets and Stagil Workflows and Fields for Confluence. So until then, thank you for attendance. Thank you for joining the webinar. I hope you could get some great insight. Remember that you can have 20% discount for buying a new Stagil navigation for Confluence or Jira. And of course, if you have questions, again, just don't hesitate and ask us. And yeah, otherwise, hopefully see you tomorrow.
Yeah, and enjoy your day. Probably a lot of you will now join the Atlassian Remote Summit. So have fun and hopefully see some of you tomorrow. Take care.
Bye.